So I'm still looking for the perfect strings. Since I used, how did I use? Right, I used the Barastro Gold, normal size, medium gauge, I guess, E string, which was pretty good. So I said, well, you know, if the Barastro E string is good, perhaps I should try the whole set. So I got the Barastro Tonica set, stuck it on here, and immediately the A string was just dead. So I took the A string off and put the A string back on from the D'Addario Pro Artes, and it's got part of the string was smushed, but it seems to work. Also, I didn't really like the E string, so I ended up putting the old E string back on, or the one from there, and it sounded okay. Does that sound all right? Sound on all this stuff, but it depends on a lot of things, and one of them is the humidity. Which is 73%. My experience is that the higher the humidity, the better the violin sounds. I think probably true on all of my violins. I don't know if it's a fact, but it's something I've discovered. Anything 50% lower, the violin starts to sound a little metallic. So I have a dehumidifier. Boom. Down here somewhere. I haven't had to use it in many months because it's been hot and humid in Virginia, so. But I always keep it above 50 if at all possible. Sometimes in the winter that's not really possible. So anyway, what is the deal here? What is the deal? Let's go this way. It's just really dark. It's just dark. Yes, I realized I haven't done one of these things, so I decided I would do another one of these things. More like a vlog than a fiddle learning thing, but that's part of the process of learning, really. You have to dedicate time to it, and when you get sidetracked by issues like, having to go down to Florida from Richmond, Virginia, and get your mother and find some place for her to stay and take care of all her financial affairs and her condo and her possessions and all that kind of stuff, get a little sidetracked. Although I do practice still just about every day. Even when I went down to Florida, I took the violin and played a couple tunes. Just keep my fingers going. Seems like mysteriously, automatically, your fingers will find the right spot on the fingerboard if you just keep playing a lot. As the case may be. The rosin makes a big difference too. I have no scientific, actually all I have is scientific evidence. Nobody's really told me. Some lady at the violin store said, oh, if it's in a wooden box, it's bad, so she sold me this stuff, and that's pretty good. Then I was looking online, and people were going, oh, you know, the rosin makes a huge difference in the sound, so then I bought some higher quality supposed rosin. I probably already said this. And it's, you know, it's good. It's different. It grips a little bit more, I think, than this stuff. So depending on the humidity level, you can use that, but going between the two is a little difficult because you get it all up on the bow and strings a little bit. You can see that, but here, let's walk over here. Let's see if this is better or worse. Better or worse? Better, I'd say. I don't know if I can really play with my glasses on because I can't really see down here. Debating whether to spend $30, $50, or $100 to go see Joshua Bell. Should be really pretty cool tonight with Richmond Symphony. Consistent grip, you need to start with no rising on the string.